This screencast gives an example of what is known as capillary rise. So let's say we have some tube here that has some radius. And if you have a fluid that is known as a wetting fluid, you have capillary rise. And it occurs because the surface tension, which we define with this sigma, which is the molecular attraction along the length of a surface, if the attraction between the tube and the liquid is strong enough to overcome the attraction of the molecules, they're able to be pulled up the inside of the straw. So if you have a wetting fluid, what you end up with is a rise with this kind of dip of the fluid within the tube. So the governing equation for capillary action or capillary rise is that the height it rises is 2 times the surface tension times the cosine of the angle between the fluid and the tube, divided by the specific weight of the liquid times the radius of the tube. So let's say we have an ant. We'll call him Andy the Ant, and he wants to drink lemonade, but he's lazy. So he wants to use capillary rise to calculate what diameter of straw to use. So if the lemonade's going to flow up the straw when he inserts it, we have to figure out the radius and therefore the diameter of the straw that he needs. So we're going to assume that lemonade has the same properties of water. So we look up our properties of water at 20 degrees C. And we find that the surface tension is 0.0728 newtons per meter, and our specific weight is 9.789 kilonewtons per meter cubed. So the angle between the two, the fluid and the tube, is 0, and the cosine of that angle is 1. So the last thing we need to know is what is the height of the straw. So let's assume that straws are 6 inches long. So we have to change that into meters to keep our units straight. So our h is 0.1524 meters. And now all we have to do is plug in our numbers. So our radius is going to equal 2 times 0.0728 newtons per meter times 1, all divided by 9.789 times 10 to the third, be careful, that's kilonewtons, newtons per meter cubed, times our height, which is 0.1524 meters. So when we calculate this radius, it is 9.8 times 10 to the minus 5 meters, or our diameter is 1.96 times 10 to the minus 4th meters, which equals 0.195 millimeters. That's an awfully narrow straw, but remember that Andy the Ant has a pretty small mouth.